All praises to the Most High God. Read what you got, my brother.
Jeremiah chapter 5, 4 to 1.
Read. Read what the Bible say, brother.
Run ye to and through the streets of Jerusalem.
Oh, the streets of what?
Jerusalem.
Uh-huh.
And see now.
And see now, and know, and see in the poor places thereof.
Start now.
Read.
In the broad places thereof, if ye can find a man, if there be any that executive judgment.
If there be any that executive judgment.
That seeketh the truth.
That seeketh what?
The truth.
That's what's wrong with people. They don't want to hear this truth. And they're trying everything that they can to keep people from hearing this truth.
That's right.
But you're a liar. Because God is always going to be the winner. You're going to be the loser. That's what the problem is. People are so angry today when this truth come out. They don't have nothing but hate in their heart for one another. But this truth is now being revealed.
That's right.
And it's not going to stop coming out, brothers and sisters. So whether you like it or not, this truth will be revealed, even though your churches are not going to tell you this truth. But we come out here to speak bold for the Most High God. Read, brother.
And I will pardon it. And though they say, the Lord liveth, surely.
They lie. They holler about they love God and the Lord liveth and all this kind of stuff. But what do? They continue to do wickedness every single day.
That's right. Surely they swear falsely, O Lord, are not thy eyes upon the truth.
Because their eyes are not upon the truth. When we came over here in slavery, their eyes weren't upon the truth. Their eyes were continuing to deceive and to lie to us. But now when we know this truth, they try to stop our microphones from going because they don't want nobody to know this truth. That is a sad commentary. Read, brother.
Thou hast stricken them, but they have not grieved.
See, the Most High God has punished you, but you ain't grieving. You continue to be the same way that you was, and you still that way today. Even though he's punishing you, you still won't change from your wicked ways.
That's right. Thou hast consumed them, but they have refused to receive correction.
They don't have no ways or intentions to receive correction.
That's right.
Everybody want to live in idolatry. Everybody want to live in sin and iniquity. But nobody wants to live in the truth. What's wrong with the truth?
That's right.
What's wrong? Why is the truth so hateful? Why do people hate this truth? Why do they hate this Bible? Because they know that this Bible is talking to a certain people. But we didn't know it, but now we're waking our people up. So-called black man, so-called Mexican, so-called Native American Indian, so-called Chileans, and all those sort of people. Everybody's being woken up now, but now they want to hate. We're not surprised. Been hating us all our life. We don't expect nothing but hate from you. All praises to the Most High God. Read.
They have made their faces harder than a rock.
They have made their faces what, brother?
Harder than a rock.
They made their faces harder than a rock.
They have refused to return.
They have refused to return to the Most High God.
Therefore, I said, surely these are poor. They are foolish, for they know not the way of the Lord.
They are poor, they are foolish, because they know not the way of the Most High God. That's what, we got 613 commandments, but America has over 6,000 commandments.
That's right.
But you break your neck to keep man's commandments, but you won't keep none of God's commandments. Read.
Then the judgment of the Yahweh.
The the judgment of God,
I will get me unto the great man and will speak unto them.
He's going to get you of the men that speaking this truth so that you can hear it. And once you heard this truth, you got to start living according to the way that the Bible tell you. Because there is no more sacrifice for sin once you've been told the truth.
For they have known the way of the Lord.
They have not known the way of the Lord.
And the judgment of their Yahweh.
And the judgment of God, they don't know. But that day is coming. See, people think just because they die that they've already been judged. But God gonna raise you back from the dead.
That's right.
And everything that you've done, he gonna judge you. And you know what? Then the shoe is gonna be on the other foot. How you like it? It's called karma. It's called recompense. Everybody got to pay a recompense
That's
for what they've done to God's people. That's what the Bible say. But they don't want you to deal with the Bible. That's why they make out 3, 4, 5, 10 Bibles every year to try to keep you from thinking that the truth is coming out. But they don't want you to know this truth. That's why they keep making all these different Bibles and stuff, so they can conclude people that God did not include in his promise. God did not include everybody in his promise. We got to start to understand who it is that God is talking to.
That's right.
And them preachers in them churches, they going to hell for telling our people lies.
But these have altogether broken the yoke.
They have broken the yoke. They've come out of prison. They've come out of slavery. Read.
And burst the bounds. Wherefore a lion out of the forest shall slay them.
Shall do what to them?
Shall slay them.
Shall slay them.
And a wolf of the evenings shall spoil them. A leopard shall watch over their cities.
Say what?
A leopard shall watch over their cities.
A leopard shall watch over the cities.
Everyone that goes out thence shall be torn.
And everyone that going out, everyone that's being disobedient and contrary to God's words, they shall be torn to pieces.
That's right.
Read.
In pieces, because their transgressions are many and their backsides are decreased.
Because their transgressions are many and their backside are continue to be increased.
That's right.
They backslide better than Michael Jackson. That's all they do is backslide against the word of God.
How shall I pardon thee for this?
How can I forgive you for when you continue to keep doing the same thing over and over? How can I forgive you?
Their children have forsaken me.
The what?
Their children have forsaken me.
Even your children have forsaken me. Your children are doing...
Turn that back up.
Your children are forsaken me.
That's good. Read.
And sown by them that are no gods.
Because they believe in those that are no God. They believe in Islam, a rock.
That's
they
right.
believe in Buddha, a statue. They believe in Christianity, wood. They don't believe in the movable God, Yahweh, and his son, Yahushua. But they believe in all the things that can't breathe, that can't hear, that can't see, and definitely can't answer none of their prayers.
That's right. When I had fed them to the full, they then commit adultery.
When I fed you to the full, when I brought you out of the wilderness, when I brought you out of the land of Egypt, he fed you to the full when you were complaining about you didn't have no food. He gave you manna and he gave you quail.
Right.
And he fed you to the full. And you continue to be disobedient to your God.
And assembled themselves by troops in the harlot's house.
and they have assembled themselves by troops in the harlot's house. Who is the harlot? That's America right. is the harlot. It is the great whore. That's what it is.
They were as fat horses in the morning. Everyone eat after his neighbor's wife.
Everybody was lusting and everything, trying to have sex with their brother's wife. Stinky, dirty, low-down brothers.
That's right.
That's why God is punishing you, because you hate one another and you doing things that you shouldn't be doing against your brothers and your sisters.
Sure.
Read.
Shall I not visit for these things, saith the Lord?
He gonna visit you. And when he do visit you, he's coming back to destroy you.
And shall not my soul be avenged on such a nation as this?
As a nation like this, America, God is going to destroy you and your jobs and everything else.
That's right.
You wicked demon. That's what you are. A bunch of wicked demons. Read.
Go ye up upon her walls.
Uh-huh.
And destroy, but make not a full end.
See, he's telling them, go up against these walls and start killing these people. But don't kill all of them. Don't make a full end yet.
That's
Read.
Right. Take away her battlements.
Take away her what?
Her battlements.
Take away her battlements.
For they are not the Lord's.
Because they are not the Lord. They don't belong to the Lord. The Lord ain't dealing with them.
That's right. For the house of Israel.
For the who?
The house of Israel.
No, the house of America.
Israel.
No, the house of Spain.
Israel.
No, the house of China.
Israel.
The house of Russia.
Israel.
The house of America.
Israel.
The house of Israel, brothers and sisters.
And the house of Judah.
And the house of Judah, the southern kingdom.
Have dealt very treachery against me.
You have went against your God, the one that has did everything for you. You have went against your God and start serving other gods.
Serve the Lord.
Says who?
Serve the Lord.
The Lord said it, not me. Because the preacher's soul ain't going to tell you. He's going to tell you everything is all good.
Long
as you paying them tithe.
They have belied the Lord and said, it is not he, neither shall evil come upon us.
Evil shouldn't be even coming upon us. Because we shouldn't be living in sin.
That's right.
We shouldn't be living foul. We shouldn't be having all this hate in our heart that we have for one another.
That's right.
Read.
Neither shall we see sword nor famine. And the prophet shall become wind, and the word is
the
not.
The prophet shall become what, brother?
Become wind.
The prophet shall become wind. That means they're going to be removed out of the way.
That's right. And the word is not in them.
Because God is not in any of those prophets. The ones that you hold in high regards. The one that you have so much respect for. God say that what, brother?
The wind and the roar is not in them.
That's right. The wind is not in them.
Thus shall it be done unto them.
They're going to be removed. They're going to be restored, because that's what God said, not
right.
me. See, people have a tendency to get mad with you because you out here bringing what God say, because they ain't never heard it before. Because the preachers in the churches are not going to tell you the truth. They're going to continue to tell you lies to keep you on the bottom.
Yeah.
Because you're giving them that tithe money, that's all they care about. But your salvation, they don't have no interest in your salvation.
Wherefore, thus saith the Lord.
Thus saith who?
Thus saith the Lord.
No, the preacher.
Thus saith the Lord.
Grandmama.
Thus saith the Lord.
Me.
Thus saith the Lord.
We.
Yahweh of hosts, because ye speak this word. Behold, I will make my words in thy mouth fire.
See, God, these words is fire, and people are wood. And when you speak these words, they hate it. It's just like when you put fire to wood, it burns. That's what this world do to you. This world will burn you up when you are in sin. And you don't want this world to go out, but the world is going to go out anyway. Read, brother.
And this people would, and it shall devour them. Though I will bring a nation upon you.
The Bible said that he's going to bring a nation against you, Israel.
From far.
From afar. Christopher Columbus.
That's right.
Cortez. Balboa. Ponce de Leon. Lewis and Clark. That's what he's going to do. He's going to bring a nation against you from afar.
That's right. O house of Israel. Saith the Lord.
That's what the Most High God said.
It is a mighty nation.
It's going to be a mighty nation.
It is an ancient nation.
It is an ancient nation.
A nation whose language thou knowest not.
You don't even understand their language. You don't understand their laws, their ways, and everything. And you've been taught those ways. That's why you lost over here in America today.
Understanding what they say.